Hello friends, welcome to Knowledge Booster. This time we have covered current affairs of first week of August 2016. As we know, current affairs take a lot of importance in our life. In our busy schedule, we do not have that much time that we can cover all of the things which is happening around. So I found a shortcut method that we can create a video in which we will put news or updates week by week, and you can cover that. You can download this video and take it with you and listen when you are free, while traveling, or whenever when you have time. I have also segregated parts like economy updates, banking sector updates, national state news, international news, sports news, science and other news, appointments, award givens, eulogy. Purpose is not only to cover current affairs, but also the perspective is people who are targeting competitive exam in this year or in coming year, they should also be get help from these videos, because current affairs section is always there, and it also help in a corporate to enhance our position, because we have to keep updated ourselves in each panel. Economy updates. Citibank holds its forecasting for 2016-17 at GDP growth 7.7 by considering the monsoon impact in rural areas and 7 pay commission. In rural areas, agricultural sector got boosted up if monsoon is good, and 7 pay commission was also given by central government. HDFC has become a first ever brand who raised up 30 billion by issuing masala bond or rupee denominated bond in London Stock Exchange. So it reflects how good reputation has built up of Indian financial sector or financial market in outside world. HDFC is a good example. Now a few others will definitely get through by these rupee denominated bonds, and it will also help to Britain after the post Brexit. With the banking sector, as we can see, there are a lot of NPA issues. So our private lender ICICI Bank has teamed up with the private equity major Apollo Global Management to launch an asset reconstruction company. It will work as a factor. Tata Capital Housing Finance launched scheme Prapti, which targets low income group for lightning tap 4%. Purpose is financial inclusive growth in rural areas, which is very important thing in a developing economy, because there should be economy equality in economy. So it will help out in that term. BSE signed an agreement with the IIT Kanpur for cyber security. GST bill also got an approval in Rajya Sabha as well. The government had amended at the RBI Act through Finance Act 2016, provided for Monetary Policy Committee with specific inflation goal, that is 4+1+2+2-2. Now we can say that only governor will not be responsible for monetary policy, but the team will. It is a good, as we can see, there were a lot of tussles between RBI and Finance Ministry, so now it would be sorted out. Oracle India announced a corporate citizenship. These are banking updates. Collaboration with the State Bank of India and launched the change program, which will support education and learning, women empowerment and rural skill development in the country. These all are very important factors of economy growth in any developing economy. But the purpose of SBI is also either it is a CSR, but it will help economy in a good chase. So we can see that that was a good movement by State Bank of India and Oracle as well. RBI Raghuram Rajan launched a Sachet to curb illegal collection of the deposits a week before the announcement of the monetary policy. Sachet is a website, there you can see which site is genuine, asking your money. Either it is a financial services website or financial web services a company, or any job portal, or any portal. Now there was really not any platform before that where we can cross check if that site is a good. Now it is a good to have this site, really a good initiative by Dr. Raghuram Rajan. Rajasthan government has initiated an SMS based system through which midday meal data will be sent every day by schools to toll free number that will be monitored at the state level. It will definitely reduce the corruption by reducing the wastage, as well as it will also increase the quality of food. Tripura entered in the broad gauge railway map of country with Union Railway Minister Mr. Suresh Prabhu flagging off Agartala to New Delhi Tripura Sundari Express. It also flagged off Agartala to Bangladesh. So we can see how our sectors are doing well in every manner. Madhya Pradesh government has allowed Patanjali to set up 500 crore rupees food processing unit in the Dhar district in state. Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi launched Mission Bhagiratha Talangana. The scheme has been launched by state government with an objective to provide safe drinking water to all. As we have seen, Polavaram dam issue is going on in the Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. And here we can see safe water and Ayurveda. Both are going by par and in the right track and in the developing track. So we can see this will definitely will help out in for a good environment. Under the Memorandum of Understanding, Tata Trust and the Gilead will form a joint program committee to implement activities related to prevention, awareness and education, testing and treatment of the viral hepatitis. India has recently become a hepatitis free country. Infrastructure firm Tata Projects kicked off for 1676 crore rupees rejuvenation program of the Daryavati River in Rajasthan. West Bengal government passed a proposal to rename the state as just as Bengal. West Bengal was given by Britishers because Bangladesh was East Bengal at that time, East Pakistan at that time. Now it is Bangladesh. Japan Prime Minister Shinzo Abe appointed conservative ally Tomomi Inada as a defense minister. She is a lawyer and she has also worked as a law minister in a council for Japan. Communist Party of Nepal Mayo's chairperson Pushpa Kamal Dahal Prachand was elected as the 39th Prime Minister of Nepal on a Wednesday with more than 360 lawmakers voting for them. There are two parties or two segregation in Nepal. One is a Madhesi and Nepalese. Madhesis are also in a UP and a Bihar. So Prachand is from a Madhesi. India has signed a memorandum of understanding with Mozambique to import 375,000 tons of the pulses because the pulses prices of pulses were shooting up this quarter. Either it increases our current account deficit, but when there is a need, then our government goes for that because there is nothing beyond that need. Okay, 375,000 tons of pulses. I don't know whether it is good, but when prices start shooting up, it reflects there is a demand and there is a shortage. So next is sports news. India will host Kabaddi World Cup in October this year, featuring 12 countries. Mr. Pradeep Narwal produced a terrific performance as the Patna Pirates beat Jaipur Pink Panther in the final of season 4 in a Pro Kabaddi League, and it has also become a first team which got announced as a winner twice. Last year they were also winner. So we can say that this is the first team, and Mr. Pradeep Narwal was a performer of that Kabaddi. But it's also a very interesting game, getting a very interesting terms in terms of the public. International Olympic Committee has added 5 new sports to the program for Tokyo 2020. Baseball, karate, skateboarding, sports climbing and surfing. Surfing is what I have shown in a figure. Next summer Olympics coming in Tokyo 2000 will invite athletes to compete for medals in the 6 sports. When archer Zahara Nemati carried the Iranian flag into the Marcana Stadium in Rio Olympics 2016, she created a new ground for Islamic country, and it also showed how a women empowerment is being risen up in different countries. I mean everywhere. Iran is also one of them. India is also one of them. China conducted a surprise lift of its flagship Long March 3B booster carrying the country's first Tantong mobile communication satellite. Before it was using France, Russia and the US models. Now it has its own. Moreover, it is the first satellite of China's homemade mobile telecom system, which carries mobile telecom system and a key part of the country's space information infrastructure. ISRO is also in follow up. Next month, ISRO will also launch a GSAT 18 appointments. Air Marshal NGS Dhillon took charge as a senior air staff officer of the Western Air Command. He took over from Air Marshal B. Suresh, who assumes charge of air officer in a charge personnel at air headquarters. So notice Air Marshal NGS Dhillon. Senior Indian Revenue Service Officer Rani Singh Nair is said to be appointed to the Central Board of Direct Taxes chairperson, with incumbent Aklesh Jindal retiring soon. So here the point is Rani Singh Nair and Air Marshal NGS Dhillon. IRS officer also selected from UPSC IAS. Former Defense Minister Yuriko Koek has been elected Governor of the Tokyo, the first woman to lead Japan's capital. Pharma Major Cipla has appointed Kedar Upadhyay as its Global Chief Financial Officer. So here the point is Yuriko Koek and Mr. Kedar Upadhyay. Yuriko Koek, again it shows of women empowerment. How women are doing good in everywhere, in we can see worldwide. It's good, really good. Nita Ambani was formally elected as an individual member of International Olympic Committee. This also comes under appointment. Again, a lady, a very rich, a very powerful lady. The reason to select her for International Olympic Committee, cannot go for that, but she has been selected for that. It shows how powerful she is now, and thanks to selectors as well as the government. So next is awards. Kusumanjali Sahitya Samman 2016. Writer, politician and the media personality, member of parliament Virendra Kumar and the author Kusum Kemani were awarded this year Kusumanjali Sahitya Samman for the contribution to literature in the Malayalam and the Hindi. So here things to note. Member of parliament Virendra Kumar and Kusum Kemani. Kusumanjali Sahitya Samman, Kusum Kemani and Mr. Virendra Kumar. Virendra Kumar is also member of parliament. So these are things to take and literature in Malayalam and Hindi. Today's Traveler Award 2016. Arunachal Pradesh received a major boost with the state receiving today's Traveler Award. National Tourism Award. Saint Fe based Tiffany Pearson is an American women journalist who penned an exhilarating account of Kerala. That is a snapshot on the state's palm-fringed beaches, gorgeous topography, serene spirituality and the hospitality has won National Tourism Award. Here we can see how foreigners are getting advantage. I mean, how they know the value of Indian tourism in today's context, and we go outside of India for the same. Lifetime Achievement Award at the Goa Film Festival. Bollywood filmmaker Mr. N. Chandra was honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award. Mr. N. Chandra, during the 8th Goa State Film Festival, between August 5th to 8th. Rajiv Gandhi National Sadbhavna Award. Singer Shubha Mudgal will be awarded the Rajiv Gandhi National Sadbhavna Award for her outstanding contribution towards the promotion of communal harmony, peace and goodwill. So Miss Shubha Mudgal and Mr. N. Chandra. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more instant updates. Someone has well said, do good for someone today and it will come back to you tomorrow. And trust me, it will not take anything from you to subscribe, but definitely it will give you instant notifications of videos, of updates further. And for next I will put week 2 as well as the general knowledge apart and few things which are happening in next week. Thank you.